Hey, happy Thursday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I got a big update on what's going on in the tropics. We still have Invest 94L. I will update you on that. Still showing that could still become something at the very last second, bringing maybe some rainfall. But we still have Invest 95L, and we have another strong wave that just came off the coast of Africa. This is going to be Invest 96L. These are the two waves that the models are seeing going back to back towards the islands. So far, Invest 95L is at 29 miles per hour winds, moving west at 15 miles per hour. So as soon as it gets a surface low, it's probably going to be designated as a tropical depression already. So whichever one forms, it don't really matter. It's just a name. They got Beryl, they got Chris coming, but the majority show that it will go towards the southern islands, really towards St. Lucia, getting hit the hardest out of this tropical wave. Remember, it's gonna be back to back on those, and showing they potentially will go right into either the Western Caribbean, maybe into the Gulf, or maybe following the Euro and going towards Central America, but coming right back towards the Gulf again. So I'm gonna show you all the latest information in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. That way you get all the latest information. I do afternoon updates on the tropics. Now we have severe weather for the lower 48 for the United States for today. I will have that in a video after this one. I wanna keep them separate. That way people don't have to run through the timestamps, which are in the description below, just to get to the latest tropical update. So I'm gonna show you that information now. Now you also can see that it is hitting a lot of dust. It still has a dry air in front of it, but it's still bulldozing right on through. Matter of fact, if you look a little bit lower than the 500 millibars and look at the 850 millibars, you can see really what's going on. You still got the dust in there, but it's not as thick as the upper levels. The lower levels, you got dust, but all this is propagating to the west all together. So it's not going to run into this big patch of dust right here, because that's going to be moving by the time this moves. So our latest official update from National Hurricane Center's Invest 94L is at 30% in 7 days, 10% in the next 48 hours. It is still conducive for development as it goes from Western Caribbean. So I'm going over to Yucatan. It's going to weaken down, bring some rainfall, then go into the western half, the southern half of the Bay of Campeche, into the Gulf of Mexico, and maybe form up at the last second right before Mexico again, bringing y'all some more rainfall. So watch out for that flooding. Invest 95L is at 70% in the next 7 days, 40% in the next 48 hours. They are expecting a tropical storm to form out of this system as it moves westward 15 to 20 miles per hour. So when you look at the intensity and chances for these storms, you can see with Invest 94L, maybe hit a tropical storm sometime around Sunday all the way till Tuesday. Some of that region would just be a high-end tropical depression, low-end tropical storm. That's pretty much at this point just maybe some more winds coming with this, not much more. Still going to bring a lot of flooding in y'all direction. That's not going to change. Now when you look at Invest 95L, latest intensity guidance show that it could become a Cat 1 hurricane by the time we go all the way into Monday, and then strengthen potentially towards a major hurricane. And it's not just one, but it's multiple hurricane models and other models. So there is a lot of models showing a Cat 2 or Cat 3 hurricane could become out of this by the time we go from Monday into Tuesday, that fast. Rapid intensification. Now I want you to look at this. This is a graphics from National Hurricane Center, literally in 48 hours. You can see where this tropical wave is, and in 72 hours, still moving a little bit on that northward push. It's not on the northern side, it's on the southern side, because this is where your wave is down here. But you can see how it's moving a little bit northward on that last evolution. So it could start going a little bit on that northern track. Also, when you look at your sea surface temperatures, you can see that you're hitting a lot of 80s. You're in the mid 80s and all this dark brown, but all this light brown is starting to get towards the high 80s. Already is 80 degree temperatures to sustain a tropical system. So it is going to start hitting a lot of not only warm waters already, but warmer waters once it passes the islands. Showing you chances for a tropical depression. I know you see something here. This is right now. This is as we get this front, might get a storm system, a front induced low off into the Atlantic. While you have Invest 94L, weakening down, his best chance to form is going to be by the Western Caribbean. So you might see a tropical depression, maybe even a strong one, weaken down over landfall, maybe not have enough time to get back together. But you can see Invest 95L definitely chances to become a tropical depression, 100% chance by the time it reaches the southern islands. And look how it keeps going to the west. You see all this grows right here also because the Euro is taking it in that direction. Chances for a tropical storm. You can see here that you definitely have a weak chance with Invest 94L, but still strengthened at the last second by the Western Caribbean. Chance for a weak tropical storm, still strong tropical depression. Invest 95L, 100% chance become a tropical storm by the time it reaches the southern islands. Now, even though it shows that it weakens down afterwards, this is how these models always run. Later on, when it gets closer, it's going to stay stronger even longer. That's the way it always is. And chances for a hurricane so far with the Euro, showing it has the best chance right below Dominican Republic, right past Puerto Rico. Best chance for a hurricane is going to be right around that region. Remember, this is going to be north and east side loaded with the winds and the rain. So it is going to bring a lot of impacts if that showed true. But that would take that northern track, just like we're starting to see with National Hurricane Center. You can see this here as you check for just a tropical depression in 4 or 5 days. All right, it goes in that north-northwest track 6, 7, 8 days, goes right towards Jamaica. Starts showing maybe it can start taking that southwesterly track, but it does go right towards Jamaica. Everything will update after this as it goes 9 and 10 days. More than likely, we go towards the Western Caribbean, going right into the Gulf of Mexico with a slight chance it could get pulled around the high pressure. Now, the big thing is this high pressure. And this high pressure is going to be over here. We're going to have a dome going way out here, pushing in this direction. But if this high pressure retracts back, it is going to be pulling in this direction and allow it to go in that direction. So the high pressure is going to be there, but it is going to retract back and breathe out back and forth. That's what it does. So if it comes earlier, it could take that northern track. If it comes later, it'd take that western track. As you go 11, 12 days out, showing it could go to the western Gulf of Mexico or right along the southeast, Florida and the Carolinas. That's what we're seeing so far. So far, Invest 95L could go right towards Jamaica as we go 6 days away and then potentially go towards the Gulf in 10 days or the Western Gulf in 9 to 10 days. Here's another one here, also a green that's going right towards Jamaica as you go anywhere from 6 days towards 8 days and 9 days. So you need to be aware of Jamaica, because if it is taking this path, all the wind and the rain impacts will be on you. You can see Invest 94L strengthening back up towards a tropical storm right before landfall, somewhere around northern Mexico, just like what y'all just had. So expect probably the same impacts like y'all just had. Look at this right here, Invest 95L in 4 days. A green is strengthening up going towards the southern islands, and it is trending a little bit northern on this run, that it could take that northern track, just like we're seeing in the 48 to 72 hours, and that would take that path a little bit further in 5 days, going right over the northern half of the islands, showing it will be a little upkick, and it won't be down here towards the southern islands. Now you can see when you go from 5 days towards 6 days, that it really travels right below Puerto Rico, agreeing with a lot of these members that it will be a little more northern as it goes through 6 days. And as you go 7 days and beyond, this is where it starts spreading out. But you can see a general area where this is going to be. So Jamaica, you definitely need to keep your eye on it. I don't see that southern track that Euro is showing in the latest model run being really the trend at this point. So as we start going 8 days and 9 days, this is where it starts getting a little bit far-fetched. It gets a lot further than what we can tell what's going to happen. So it's just too far to know for sure. But so far, this is looking concerning, everybody. That's why I want to do afternoon updates every day, just so we know what's going on. Because look right here, towards 10 days, there's multiple possibilities. But instead of three groups, now we pretty much have two groups. We have a wide array of possibilities over here, whether it's timing with that high pressure retracting back. But we have a strong group agreeing together that it could go in the same path as Invest 94L, only stronger, and then going right towards the Western Gulf. So far, it's just a wide area of spread of impacts anywhere along the coast, the Gulf, also the Western Gulf. But wait, didn't you say we was on a break or going into a break? Yes, and I have big updates about that. You can see right now, Invest 95L riding right through that dust. A according to this run, and still going on at north-northwest track, showing there's a big plume on Invest 96L also as that pushes through and takes that north-northwest track. Still showing we have dust coming through. It is where we're going to start getting lighter and lighter as well as we go through July. But also, all this dust is northern. All these waves are coming off southern, so it's not coming off in the dust. It's only hitting the dust as it tries to turn north. Plus, what comes into our break is going to be the sinking air that's coming in from the Pacific. And I got a big update about that as well. Unfortunately, I don't think it's going to be good news. So just trying to show you a kind of trend. You can see right here with the GOES satellite, it takes it northern, just like we've been seeing with the possible National Hurricane Center in 48, 72 hours. Go right above Puerto Rico and go by the Bahamas and turn. Now, when you check and see what kind of pressure it's talking about, it is talking about a potential hurricane as it goes towards the northern islands, towards the Virgin Islands, right above Puerto Rico, then goes out into the Atlantic, and maybe got to watch for possible impacts towards Bermuda. Now, the latest on the Euro shows that Invest 94L will start strengthening at the last moment as it goes into the Bay of Campeche, the southern half Gulf of Mexico. It's going to weaken down from landfall. Still bring a lot of rainfall, but it could be a strong tropical depression, weak tropical storm. Maybe bring some 40 or 50 miles per hour winds with that as it comes on land. It's a possibility. Got to stay updated. But it also takes Invest 95L as a weak system still as it goes towards the southern islands. And as it goes into the Caribbean, it looks like it takes that north-northwest push. Then it takes a western-southwest push and starts strengthening up towards a hurricane towards Nicaragua and Honduras. Then, after that, it goes over land, so it stays weak, but it tries going right back towards the Gulf, right back northerly. Now, when you look at your hurricane models, you can see here with your HWRF, the Hurricane Weather Research and Forecasting Model. This is your parent, so you can see the whole glimpse of what's going on. You can see there's another tropical wave right in front of it. This one actually gets messed up not only by shear, but by the dust. But Invest 95L and the one behind it start strengthening up, showing actually as you go into 4 days, it will go from a tropical storm into a hurricane in those warm waters, not getting shear, not getting the dust, and potentially becoming a major hurricane towards the southern islands, mostly towards St. Lucia as it goes through, but it will be northern impacts. It will go towards Martinique. It will go towards St. John's. But this is very concerning, showing this strength, and it could get worse. You can see here when you look at your relative humidity, you have your precipitation with the system. All that dust is northerly. This tropical wave over here going towards the islands, bringing a little bit of rainfall, gets eaten up by the shear. But Invest 95L is breathing very good. You can see all the outflows coming on it. It is breathing good all the way around this system, and it is not getting affected by that dust. The dust is too far to the north, and it keeps traveling together. You see that? And then the other one right behind it on this run goes northerly into the MDR and goes right to that dust, right towards Suicide. Showing so far as you go towards Monday, it could impact the southern islands, not only with something stronger than a tropical storm, showing one of your worst case scenarios. Unfortunately, it could be a potential major hurricane. Now, this is not forecasted by National Hurricane Center yet. This is just one model run, but I'm going to show you the trend. This would impact the islands badly if this was to show true. When you look at your 10 meter winds, you can see your winds are actually very powerful in this storm, and it goes all the way up to 105 knots. We're talking over 115, 120 miles per hour winds. That is closest towards the core. You can see it does go right over to southern islands. And so far, a lot of widespread impacts is somewhere in between 40 and 50 knot winds. So definitely a lot of winds coming with that system if that was to play out. Now, there's a wide range of options. When we look at the hurricane analysis forecast system, these models are made just for hurricane season. Shows Invest 95L strengthening up potentially towards a beginning of a hurricane. Not a major hurricane, but a hurricane. And that second one will be Invest 96L, could be going in the same direction while this goes right towards Jamaica as a hurricane. Then you have a tropical storm and another potential hurricane coming in your direction, showing all the heavy rainfall will be around the southern islands. Well, let's not just go by one. Here is Hurricane Analysis Forecast System B. We also have a second one. And you can see Invest 95L, that it does go towards the southern islands, agreeing that it'd be a little bit stronger of a hurricane. So we have anywhere from a a beginning of a hurricane, a low-grade hurricane, to a major hurricane coming around Monday for the Southern Islands. And you see Invest 96L, the one right behind it, showing the same thing, going right on that western jog as this one goes right on that west, northwest. Showing also very heavy rainfall right around the Southern Islands, a little bit further to the north on this one, but still very heavy rainfall in the southern half. Now we go with the trend and see what the GFS is seeing. You can see it's also green that as you go into Monday, it is bringing a hurricane over towards the Southern Islands as it keeps going on at west-northwest. Then as you go towards Tuesday and Wednesday, potentially getting back-to-back hurricanes. This is a 6Z, the next run with the GFS, showing it still will become a hurricane a little bit further to the north on Invest 95L. And the next one, Invest 96L, showing it be a little bit weaker, maybe a tropical depression, maybe a strong tropical depression. And then the other one still going somewhere towards Jamaica, and the second one following there as well. But on this run, showing instead of going western to the Caribbean, the high pressure retracts back and it goes into the Gulf and starts becoming some kind of system right towards Texas. That would be a strong tropical storm, maybe even a hurricane for a moment, right towards Houston. Now you can see here from your latest potential velocity anomaly with the Euro, this is the long range. I want to show you something as you look right here, as you see these two little waves in this little neutral area. This right here is Invest 95L and Invest 96L, the one right behind it, showing it will be a little bit weaker. This is concerning to me because not only this sinking air propagating to the east, that should be putting us on a break, just like I showed you with Global Tropics, nothing expected. I'm showing that this is going to curve around towards Central America, towards South America, and it's not going to affect the eastern Gulf of Mexico. It's not going to affect the eastern and central Caribbean. So that part could still be forming up and still showing that after that, once we go from July 15th, we are going to go towards a neutral phase, towards favorable environment. Now, this is what I wanted to show you. This is concerning to me. So while you see in this area here what we're dealing with in August, what is that? That is an unbelievable amount of energy coming our way, a lot of lift, a lot of favorable environment. This is going to be an issue for a lot of people, so we need to figure this one out. Now you can see this when you look at your latest MJO. So you have your sinking air moving in as you go now into July. You see you got sinking air moving in over South America. All this is pretty much staying in a neutral phase, favorable environment moving by the MDR. And as you keep going through July, you can see that sinking air stays towards South America, a little bit of Central America, and everyone else in the Caribbean will be in a neutral phase instead of unfavorable. It's just not, it's not favorable, it's not unfavorable. Whatever builds could be an issue. And the dust is going to start retracting back at this point. Now, as we go towards the 10th of July, we're going to start seeing that neutral phase, the sinking air disappearing all over South America. But we're going to start seeing that neutral phase transition to favorable environment as we go towards the end of July and into August. Really spark up what we're about to go into. I do believe that that sinking air will miss what's going to happen in our Caribbean and what could happen on the eastern side of the Gulf of Mexico. We will need to watch this. This break is only going to be for certain people. Now, before you go today, some words of encouragement. Psalm 46, 1 through 3. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. Amen. And Selah means, think about what you just heard, because you will see it. Though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you this afternoon for the update. I appreciate every single one of y'all that helped liking this video and sharing this video. It helps other people prepare the best way possible. Some people need more than just a few days to prepare for something like this. Thank you again for all your help. Remember, all glory does go to God. Yahweh, our Father in heaven. Remember, you must say his name, otherwise you're saying the Lord's name in vain. Which God are you speaking of? Yahweh, Jesus Christ, the Father of Jesus Christ. Jesus is the Son, he is the Father, and we have the Spirit within us, the Holy Trinity. So I wish the best for every single one of y'all, according to God our Father, Yahweh, forever and ever, you and your family. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day. I'll see you later on.